Colony Shakir. What you are about to see is the story of what happened to me during the most difficult time of my life. The time I was stalked by a person I did not know. During this time, I had many questions, like why me? Why now? And most of all, why is my conscious narrative in a male voice? I never got any answers. I spent most of my time toiling in my room, usually in front of my white IKEA dresser, wondering about what would happen, when he would strike, or if he would strike. Once again, no answers. More frustration. What made it worse was knowing that I couldn't call for help. He could be watching, possibly through some Canadian tire bot, telescope, or some other contraption. I don't know, I didn't think about it too much. Anyways, it usually resulted in a broken phone. From there on, it was all downhill. I tried to change my identity with a wig I bought from Party Packagers. It was only $4.99, and hell, I'm a kid, let's spend some money. It got even worse, though. On more than one occasion, I lunged at one of my family members with a knife. I slept with that knife under my pillow every night. That's when I knew I couldn't take it anymore. I had to call for help. So I called the most random person I knew.
Hello?
Trevor, it's me. I really need help. I don't know what to do. There's like someone... I don't know. You won't believe me. Someone's like...
Wait, just shut up for a second. I'm in a meeting. Mancy, what is up? Hold on, this other chick's on the other line. I'm just gonna get rid of it. It's my grandma. She's dead. I'm gonna have to talk.
Trevor, I need to talk to you. You can't. You don't have that body.
I told her my grandma was dead. That chick will believe anything. I know, you see that black wig she wears? Like, who do you think she's fooling? It's just silly. Alright, I'll talk to you later. See ya.
Then the letters started coming. First there was one, then two, then he skipped straight to six. I spent over 4 hours in my room one day reading them. It was pretty ridiculous. Many of them contained cartoons that were copied without permission. They were done in a weird kind of handwriting, possibly Egyptian. I immediately went on Google and looked up Egyptian stalkers. Didn't pan out. I was back to square one, lost, with no ideas, sitting on my bed next to my IKEA dresser, crumpling up papers. I decided to lose the wig. I was getting frustrated. Seconds later, I decided that actually I was wrong. The wig was a good idea. I put it back on and continued reading. It was getting pretty itchy, I'm not gonna lie to you. At school, it didn't get any better. The paranoia just grew.
Alicia. I was wondering if you wanted to come over to my house tonight. We can play Monopoly, or perhaps Monopoly Junior.
I have to go to class.
He seemed to buy my excuse. I think he stopped insisting.
I rather insist that you come over, Alicia. Plenty of treats.
It was getting stressful. I thought a soothing trip to the bathroom would calm my nerves. I was wrong. It was a bad experience, and one of the girls in there looked a lot like that stalker.
It's even harder to find. Well, then there must be some magic clue inside these gentle walls. 'Cause all I